All right, so my name's Danielle, and I am doing my case brief presentation on Hustler Magazine v. Falwell. The magazine, in this case, is the appellant slash petitioner to the Supreme Court, and Falwell is the appellee slash respondent. So Falwell was a public figure. He was a minister and a commentator on political affairs and public affairs. And Hustler Magazine published a parody of the Campari liquor ads, which had celebrities discussing their first time. And the magazine decided to create a fictitious first time for Falwell, saying that he lost his virginity to his mother in their outhouse. And so Falwell sued after the ad went out for libel, invasion of privacy, and intentional infliction of emotional distress. The trial court in this case was the U.S. District Court for the Western District of Virginia, and the jury found for the magazine on the libel claim, but for Falwell on the emotional distress claim. So he was then able to get tons of money in damages. The magazine appealed this to the U.S. Court of Appeals for the Fourth Circuit, and that appellate court upheld the emotional distress judgment by saying that the actual malice standard from the New York Times v. Sullivan case didn't really apply here, because for emotional distress, what needed to be proven was that the published material was outrageous enough to cause emotional harm, not that the published material was false. So it basically just said, hey, the First Amendment protection doesn't even apply here, even though this is parody. And so the magazine decided to appeal again and ask the Supreme Court to take the case. And the Supreme Court accepted it, pointing out that there are two main issues. One, do public figures suing for IIED have to prove the actual malice standard? And two, accordingly, could Falwell recover the damages? And the Supreme Court found that, yes, public figures suing for IIED have to prove actual malice, and no, accordingly, Falwell could not recover the damages that he was initially awarded by the trial court. The Supreme Court's reasoning was the First Amendment, basically upholding its protection of parody and satire, saying that even in the case of emotional distress, the original plaintiff would have to show reckless disregard for truth on publisher's side. But that didn't happen in the original case, so Falwell could not recover the damages. So the Supreme Court basically said, hey, like the jury found originally, this is just so crazy that no one would ever believe it, and you didn't prove that the magazine intentionally published it knowing it was false to hurt you, so you can't get money for your emotional distress. And this is important because the case extended the actual malice burden of proof over to IIED lawsuits, which just upholds that First Amendment protection of speech, showing that just because someone takes offense to published material doesn't mean that it's unprotected. Thanks.